Hello, I'm Clemens from exocad. Welcome to this video tutorial, which continues our bar series with a step-by-step design of a parallel bar with optional Preci-Horix and a deep dive in advanced profile editing. To achieve the workflow we show in this video, bar and implant module are required. Let's open the upper bar demo sample and start the case right away. We skip the pre-op placement and define the emergence profile margin only on both canine teeth to show the difference this causes later in this tutorial. Here, 4 points must be set by clicking, which starts the automatic detection right away. For a more accurate assessment of the space conditions, let's make a rough placement of the teeth using the current situation model as a guide. The single control point results in a circular emergence profile. If you want to adapt the bottom to the gingiva, adding more points with a left click while holding control is recommended. Now we can move the margin free or stick the points to the gingiva with a click on the circular shape below. By holding control shift, we can move the whole group together or place them individual. We can also remove a control point by holding with a left and performing a right click. For a more convex shape of the profile, we use the bottom on the right or control the shape with the sliders, like the one below, to get a more concave bottom angle. Please have a look at the abutment tutorial linked in the description for more information. Before we start the design, we need to define the insertion axis of the bar. To do this, 3 different options are available. First, by utilizing our view to define it, and a click on the Set from View button. Second, freehand, by simply dragging the tip of the green arrow, like you can see, the bar segments follow the green arrow now. And third, by using the button defined by 3 points on the gingiva, or even better, on the pre-op scan if available. These 3 points result in a patient-specific occlusal plane, which is also the foundation for the new insertion axis, oriented orthogonally to the plane, because use plane is activated. Now you know 3 ways to define the insertion axis, and you can change it at any time during the design. The bar segments will update accordingly. But note, dragging the tip or defining the insertion axis by points will only work if the checkbox use plane is activated, because this way both insertion axis and planes are linked together. To dive deeper, let's make planes visible during the design by activating the checkbox Show Planes. This is the reference plane, always displayed in green. It is typically used to define the top of the bar. And in this case, we have defined it using 3 points. But there are also various options to adjust the plane's height, such as changing the height offset. We will explore these options in the next step. Level the bar top with ease. If you want a flat bar top, orthogonal to the insertion axis, let me show you the probably fastest way to get there before we go into details. If we click on one of the upwards arrows on the bar top by holding Ctrl Shift, we align all control points at once to the reference plane. Immediately the bar is leveled neatly. Ctrl Shift also works on the bar bottom, and if you like to angle the insertion axis once more to ease inserting the denture, you can do this independently from the parallel bar top. For most of our users, this would be the ideal workflow to get a parallel bar design with minimal effort. But if you want to use planes independently of the insertion axis, let's deactivate the checkbox use plane and move the arrow aside to reveal the auxiliary plane arrow. Now the arrow has turned yellow and defines the auxiliary plane only. Because of this, the insertion direction hasn't changed and is displayed separately with a smaller green arrow. Now you can apply changes to the bar top independently from the insertion axis. By default, the yellow arrow follows the orientation of the scan data, and by manually dragging the top of the arrow, you can change it to your liking. Also, defining with 3 points is available, as we demonstrated before, but now it is influencing the auxiliary plane only. By holding the top of the yellow ball with a left and performing a right click, you align the auxiliary plane to the insertion axis. You can also do this by clicking on the reset to default button. Now you know how to create and change the auxiliary plane to your liking. Let's take a look at the advantages of these planes now. If we select and move a control point, two planes are visible, parallel to each other. The auxiliary plane, displayed in yellow, moves parallel to the reference plane, positioned at the height of the currently selected control point. It is a kind of visualizer to help you to see easily the height difference between the currently selected control point and the green reference plane that remains in place. With a double left click on the center of the control point, we can define this auxiliary plane to be the new reference plane orthogonal to the arrow we defined. Let's change the angle of our yellow arrow once more, move the point up, and repeat the double click on it. Again, the reference plane jumps to the control point we defined with a double click. Now let's benefit from planes with a single left click on any of the upwards arrows, because immediately he will jump onto the reference plane. By holding Ctrl or Shift while clicking onto the point, it will also attach one or two neighboring control points on each side to the reference plane. And Ctrl plus Shift combined while clicking level the whole bar top at once. This technique allows you to adjust the occlusal surface of the bar independently from the insertion direction, using a plane that you can define according to your own preference. You can evenly space for horizontal attachments by clicking the light blue arrow to move the facing part of the segment parallel to the auxiliary plane. Another double click updates the reference plane, so you can easily align another horizontal attachment using the same parallel alignment and height. Now the bar segments are leveled neatly, and you know how to use planes to your advantage. Later in the video, we will use planes again. For now, we can hide them for a better overview. Also, we can hide the bar control points by clicking on the pillar icon. Now, only the control points we want to edit are shown. Let's choose another bar profile and have a closer look at our pillars. Bar pillars follow the implant axis by default, what could result in undercuts. To avoid this, we can add a new control line to apply the minimum pillar angle option. Therefore, we hold down Ctrl and Shift and left click on the bar pillar. Immediately, a new control line appears, and we can see that the area above the orange line follows the insertion direction. At the Advanced tab, we can define the minimum pillar angle to be conical, up to 10 degrees, or, as we recommend for this case, 0 degree, equivalent to our parallel bar profile. If we move control points along the new orange curve inwards, our pillar becomes parallel because it is following the angle of 0 degree. Of course, we still have the freedom to increase the angle we set before to get a more conical design where needed, if desired. Now we repeat this step for all the bar pillars by moving the control line we added inwards by holding down Ctrl Shift to get a parallel pillar angle or increase the angle individual to our liking. By looking at the dorsal pillars, we can clearly see the impact of the emergence profile on their shape. Leaving it as it is results in a minimalistic, perfectly circular pillar. However, if we follow the gingival margin and support the emergence profile, like we did on both canine teeth, we achieve a more individualized design. One last time, we add a new control line to assure that all pillars follow the desired angle and in our case are parallel to our bar. Now we can move our focus back to our bar profile. Here, the Advanced tab offers an interesting option to switch from sharp to round edges. Let's take a closer look at the basal design of the bar. Therefore, I activate the cut view to visualize the impact of these different options. By manually pulling down the icons below the gingiva, you can see clearly that cropping the distance to the gingiva is activated. And if we select the pull-down checkbox as well, the icons below the bar change their shape to indicate that the already cropped basal area is now combined with a predefined distance. By setting a negative value here, we can easily add a constant pressure or a distance to the gingiva. In addition, we can manually adjust each area at any time, for example, to create space around the implants for easy cleaning. Another way is the use of borders around implants. These areas can be activated and edited individually in the first tab. By clicking the preview button, we can see that the material intersecting these areas will be removed around the implants. Let's uncheck the checkbox to leave it as it is. Now, let's focus on the bar profile and add a horizontal attachment to our bar design. First, we click on the section or the control point on the right, where we want to place it. Then, we activate Apply to Selection instead of Everywhere, and finally select the bar profile keyhole. The selected profile will appear in the selected area left from the control point we selected. To reinforce the structure, we open the bar profile parameters and determine individual values for the height and width of the bottom step by incorporating the surrounding bar design and the required space for our female part. To have the necessary space for the attachment available, we can activate the arrow pointing to it by clicking until they turn dark blue. Now, the included section is locked and is moving parallel to the reference plane. As we recommended before, showing planes is very useful, especially for parallel bar designs. Let's apply two more Preci-Horix by selecting the control point and also marking the arrow like before. Then, we click on Reapply Profile. As you can see, the horizontal attachment is now also moving in parallel. This technique allows us to lower several sections individually, which saves space, of course, but also keeps all the horizontal attachments in parallel to each other, which is important when inserting the prosthesis later. The last option listed in the Advanced tab is to reset pillar or bar to default. Let's take a look at another parallel bar design where pillars entirely disappear inside the bar. We select the primary bar profile and open the bar profile parameters to adjust it to our needs. Here, we choose height and width and set the angle for both sides to 0°. Because variable sides is activated, we have the possibility to hide the pillars inside the bar design. To achieve the best results here, we lower all the pillars that exceed our design by moving the central arrows downwards. By moving the arrow closest to the pillar, we enclose them into the bar design. Hiding the pillars works best when one control point is placed on the pillar itself, accompanied by two additional control points on both sides. By completely hiding the pillars, we no longer have to worry about the individual angles of each pillar, which saves time and simplifies the design. The gray arrows also offer an interesting option. Clicking on them will toggle the area from rounded to edged, as indicated by the shape of the arrow itself. Another click on it will restore the smooth shape. Finally, the bar design looks nice and clean. However, we have to keep in mind that allowing the software to smooth edges also results in a slight softening of the parameters. In cases where it is critical to keep exact values in certain areas, we therefore need the advanced profile editing option. If activated, we can individualize the shape of each side of a segment, what is super helpful to maintain the perfect dimensions in the defined area, but also enclose nearby areas like the columns nicely. The advanced profile editing option also provides more control points at the edges of our bar, which you can see by zooming in. This allows you to adjust the angle of a selected control point to give you greater control over your design, what will be explained in one of the next tutorials. Now we have seen different parallel bar designs and pointed out the importance of planes to achieve a perfect parallel result. In the next part of our bar series, we will continue from here to add attachments to our bar. So stay tuned, thank you for your time, and see you soon. If you'd like to learn more, our resellers are always happy to help. And in case you are looking for one-to-one training from one of our exocad experts, visit our webshop shop.exocad.com and book your personalized training online. Select from a variety of topics like DentalCAD or Exoplan Core Basics, release highlight introductions, module how-tos, question and answer sessions, system checkups, and more. Our technical help desk specialist will be happy to answer all your questions and provide you with a certificate and recording to make your learning experience as beneficial as possible for you.